You're listening to Ron Siegel Radio on ESPN Radio 1700. Now, live in studio, local and national real estate expert and consumer advocate, Ron Siegel.
And hello again. Welcome to Ron Siegel Radio. This is the show with no real boundaries as we discuss current events, financial markets, politics, sports, even poking fun at the rest of the media. This is the show that connects the dots of confusion delivered by conflicting media reports. We connect the dots so you know the actions you can take, how your family, your business can benefit from current events. Most of all, thank you for joining me. Before we get into our intriguing content today, please join me in welcoming our featured guest, first timer on Ron Siegel Radio, Rick Rivera is in the house. Carpet Pro, welcome.
Thank you very much, Ron.
Veteran as well. And repeat offender, Randy Renfro's in the house. Law offices of Randy Renfro. Welcome.
Good morning, Ron. How you doing?
Glad to have you with us as well. And let me remind you, if you ever have any home or finance-related questions, I am the consumer advocate looking out for you, and you can reach out to me directly at 800-306-1990, 800-306-1990, or ronsiegelradio.com. Just remember, that's the number you call anytime for assistance. When you call that number, it comes directly to me first. There are no operators standing by. I am it.
Quiet, numbskulls. I'm broadcasting.
While I do have a great team, when it comes to developing a financing plan, a plan to save you money, I personally work with you. Even if you don't have any needs today, save this number in your phone for future reference, 800-306-1990, 800-306-1990, and... yeah, this is kind of a boring celebration today. I'm looking at all the things we can celebrate today on this Friday, and the only one that really came up was National Grape Popsicle Day. Ow! That wasn't the sound I was looking for, but I guess that'll do. Not a lot of excitement on that one today. Let's go back to yesterday. It was Blueberry Cheesecake Day. I think I'll find some leftovers. Moving right along. Got the markets. We're watching on the markets right now. What's going on in the markets? The Dow Jones at 30, up 39 points this morning. Oil falling off a little bit. And the U.S. 10-year Treasury up just a touch. If you are a senior citizen, if you are on fixed income, the U.S. 10-year Treasury is at a whopping 1.84%. Gosh, you're going to live on that one for a long time, right? Yeah, not exciting there either. Got our second reading of the first quarter. GDP came in at a whopping 0.8%. Talk about an anemic recovery, not doing well. But it's better than the 0.5% that was in that first reading. And the economists, they were expecting it to be 0.9%, so they missed by just a little bit. Consumer sentiment, University of Michigan came in at 94.7 in May. From an additional an initial reading of 95.8, and not so hot right there either. So there's nothing really exciting there. But you got to remember the stock market. The consistent commentary from the stock market: sell in May and go away. So May is just about gone. A lot of people selling off and really ready to say adios. They're going to be taking their money, going out on different trips. And a lot of people in the stock market, the big money, they take the summer off. We'll see if that holds true this year again. Maybe there's other things that they're going to be doing, like watching what's going on, following Donald Trump. I don't know, did you get one of those McDonald's? Did you see that on his plane after he gets the 1,237 delegates he needs to become the nominee of the party? He's celebrating on his plane, eating a Big Mac, French fries, and a Diet Coke. Yeah, the breakfast of champions. Sounds good right there. What else we got going on in the news? It's probably better than what we see from the Washingtonian magazine. Unbelievable.
So I know who's asked to kick.
More of the political correct in our country. The Washingtonian magazine says that we have to stop saying, and I quote, "start a family," unquote. That's offensive. Now, I don't know what's offensive about it, but according to Bill O'Sullivan, senior editor at the Washingtonian magazine, saying start a family is offensive. It might upset people who don't have families or don't want to start a family. Really? I think he must be...
okay.
Yeah, he's probably also...
You're absolutely useless.
Useless. Unbelievable. Where do we come up with some... How do we find these people that have these type of opinions? Now, here's another one. I don't know. We might have to get into this one with a lawyer or two. But here's a new program that a lawyer is coming up with. Law professor at George Washington University Law School, John F. Banzhaf. He's saying that we need to take kids away from and out of the custody of parents who smoke. Taking kids out of the custody of parents who smoke. Now, last I checked, I may be all wet. I am not an attorney. I don't play one on TV. But it's not against the law to smoke. So you're going to take kids away from their parents if they smoke because the secondhand smoke might not be good for them. Unbelievable. Where do we come? You can't make these things up. I'm telling you, I just report these things. There's no possible way that I could make this stuff up. But going back to our commentary, I wonder when Donald got his Big Mac for the plane ride. I'm just wondering if he ordered that with a worker at McDonald's or if they holy cow, it's easy for me to speak. You can tell it's Friday morning, right? If they got involved with the former CEO of McDonald's, Ed Renzi, came out and made a comment just this week that a proposed $15 minimum wage will drive the restaurants to use automation more and hire fewer workers.
Surprise, surprise, surprise.
Had we heard that anywhere before? The machine costs $35,000 for a robotic arm. And they say that's cheaper than hiring somebody for $15 an hour. Now, to me, just remember one thing. These are business people. Just like the loony comments that came from Hillary Clinton and Elizabeth Warren the day before yesterday. Business people are in business to make money. That's what their business is for. They're not there to... Yeah, they might give to charity, but it's not a charitable endeavor. It's not a philanthropic operation. They want to make money. So when Elizabeth Warren and Hillary Clinton come out and say Donald Trump wanted to buy real estate at a low price, does that surprise anybody? Would you expect him to, only in Washington? Now, Elizabeth Warren and Hillary Clinton, they're politicians. So to me, it would make sense for them to say, well, we should pay more. That's what you get from our politicians. That's why we're $20 trillion in debt. You get somebody like Donald Trump that says, you know something? Yeah, if I can buy real estate, I'm going to buy it when the price is low, not when the price is high. Did you happen to watch, I think it was earlier this week, that Warren Buffett came out and bought $1 billion worth of Apple stock? Do you think he waited till it was at an all-time high until he bought it, or did he buy it when it was as cheap as possible? Think about it. Yet you get people going to these campaign rallies saying, oh, Donald Trump, he's a horrible person. He wanted to buy real estate cheap. Unbelievable. Where do these people come from? Well, I guess that's what happens when you get career politicians. Talking about career, this is another one of those unbelievable stories. United States Veterans Administration is now admitting that they've wrongly declared 4,000 veterans dead. They are not dead, they're alive. 4,000 of them. These are during the calendar years of 2011 through 2015. The VA terminated awards due to death of the beneficiary, and they found that 4,201 of those people that they terminated the benefits for are not deceased. Now, it's kind of interesting because then they make these people prove that they're not dead. Now, how do you prove to a Veterans Administration official that you're not dead when they act like they're dead when they're trying to help our veterans? It takes them forever to get the veterans through the process. Unbelievable. 4,201 people losing benefits. That's probably what Elizabeth Warren would say as a way to save money, I guess. I don't know. I shouldn't speak for her, but she's a little odd to me. Secret Service is on the fritz right now. 41 Secret Service agents being punished over a leak of data from the home. From one of the who is it? I got to find Senator Chavez, I think is his name. House Chairman, I guess Congressman Chavez. They released personal information and information from the House Oversight Committee. 41 Secret Service agents being punished for that right now. Hope they're alive. We're going to have to check into that and make sure that they're not part of those that are no longer living, according to the Veterans Administration. You can't make this stuff up. I just find these stories, save them for a Friday morning, and we will continue our conversations. You are listening to Ron Siegel Radio, discussing your real estate current events and the financial markets. When we come back, we've got a great broadcast with you as we celebrate our veterans this week. Randy Renfro's in the house. We've got, think about this one. I love looking at these topics. Is it possible to upgrade an unfavorable discharge? Can you correct a military record after discharge? That might be one of the topics. Maybe you got to correct the military record that you're still alive. You wouldn't think that that's something you have to correct. We're going to talk about carpet cleaning and a veteran serving that industry. Existing home sales, debunking. My tongue is not working today. Debunking credit myths. And what's the difference between a fixed rate mortgage and an adjustable rate mortgage? Which should you use, when, and why? Got a lot to cover today. You can reach me anytime. Call the off-air number, 800-306-1990, 800-306-1990, or ronsiegelradio.com. Connect with us, facebook.com/ronsiegelradio, on Twitter, @ronsiegel. Stay tuned. We'll be back in just a few.
Are you earning a safe, secure 10%+ return on your investments? Is your credit score over 800? Are you living in the home of your dreams or simply where you think you can afford? If the answer to any of these questions is no, what are you doing about it? Text ATP to 79564. Complete a 3-minute complimentary survey and the area trusted professionals of Ron Siegel Radio will reach out to you to develop a success strategy for you. Again, all you need to do is text ATP to 79564.
What if your family business could help clothe a less fortunate family? Or your restaurant could feed truly hungry people? What if you could help to comfort the lonely? Plant sustainable resources where nothing has ever grown before? Or make a child's lifelong wish come true? What if all you had to do was simply do nothing more than what your business already does every day? Would you do it? Introducing Processing for a Cause, a unique program that turns a percentage of your business's credit card volume into ongoing donation dollars for nonprofit organizations and foundations. Simply switch your credit card processing provider to Processing for a Cause and begin supporting a worthy cause today. The process is simple, and the cause will change lives forever. Processing for a Cause.
Are you a veteran, own a home, and need money? The Siegel Lending Team is here to help veterans refinance and get the money they need. The VA 100 lets you borrow up to 100% of your home's value, refinance your mortgages, consolidate credit cards, and lower your payments by an average of $700 a month. And the Siegel Lending Team knows that character means more than a credit score. Call 800-306-1990. That's 800-306-1990. Rate subject to change without notice. Licensed by the California Department of Corporations, NMLS 21037, and DRE number 01869452.
Are you a veteran, police officer, firefighter, doctor, nurse, or teacher? If so, you qualify as one of Ron Siegel's VIP heroes, and we have rewards up to $5,000 or $10,000 when you buy, sell, or refinance a home with one of the Ron Siegel Radio partners. As one of the heroes, real estate agents will rebate part of their commission, lending partners will give a credit at closing, the title company has special published rates, and many other service providers have incentives too. All you need to do is call Ron Siegel Radio at 1-800-306-1990. That's 1-800-306-1990. Or visit VIPHeroProgram.com. Just think about what you will do with all the rebates and incentives from the partners of Ron Siegel Radio. Just call us at 800-306-1990 so we can show you our appreciation for your service.
You're listening to Ron Siegel's Home and Finance Show with local and national expert Ron Siegel. Now, here's Ron.
Welcome back to Ron Siegel Radio. Within every market, there are solutions as well as tremendous opportunities. You just need some trusted guidance. That's my message. And as your consumer advocate, I will be delivering it every day on Ron Siegel Radio. Or anytime at 800-306-1990, 800-306-1990. 1990, the real-time real estate segment today. being brought to you by the area trusted real estate professionals of Ron Siegel Radio. Text PEAR, P-E-A-R, to 79564. One of the professionals will reach out to you and get you the true equity position on your real estate. Just text PEAR, P-E-A-R, 79564. New and existing home sales. Got some numbers for you. New home sales up 16.6% month over month, up 23.8% year over year. Existing home sales up 1.7% month over month and 6% year over year. These are national numbers. And remember, sometimes on the new home sales, last year the numbers were really, really small. So it makes it easier to get higher percentages. Median price nationally up 12% on new home, up 6.3% on resale. And right now we are still at unbelievable low amounts of inventory. There's a 4.7 month supply of new homes, 4.7 month supply of existing homes, both very, very low. That's why prices continue to go up, and that's why this is not, regardless of what other people are telling you, we are not in a housing bubble. I would not worry about that. A housing bubble is defined as prices going, or any bubble. How prices going up because prices are going up. Well, our prices right now are going up because of something called Economics 101. There is more demand than there is supply, and we've got great interest rates right now. That's why we're seeing these things happen. That is the real-time real estate segment, again, brought to you by the area trusted professionals of Ron Siegel Radio. Text PEAR, P-E-A-R, to 79564. Got a fun opportunity. I love chatting with Randy Renfro. He's come in several times, been gracious enough to give us some guidance. Law offices of Randy Renfro. He's an attorney and a CPA. Sounds like lots of studying, Randy.
Oh, way too much. Way too much.
I don't know. I don't think I could handle all that studying and things.
When I got out of high school, I swore I would never open another book for the rest of my life, and look what happened.
Yeah, especially because, a lot of times accounting, I mean, it's numbers, and you've got the same decimal system that's been around forever. I guess there are some accounting changes from time to time.
Right.
But when you're dealing in law, those briefings, that's all reading. That's all studying.
Right.
Holy cow.
And a lot of talking.
And a lot of talking.
Right. Okay. I did not like public speaking when I was in college, and now look, I do it all the time.
Really? So
it's funny how things change.
They do. I tell people all the time that I'm an introvert. I say, how do you talk to thousands or hundreds of thousands of people every month? I don't know. We just have a conversation over coffee.
Right.
We just sit here. So let's get into some of the interesting items. Now, you heard me talking about the deceased veterans that are not deceased, or at least the VA claiming they're deceased. And ironically enough, one of the things that we had on our list to talk about is changing a military record after discharge. That's probably a serious one to change.
Oh, yes.
Right, whether you're deceased or not.
Yes. It seems to be pretty important.
Yeah, it would be important. It seems like it should be pretty easy, too, right?
Right.
I mean, can you take my blood pressure? I think my ticker's still going.
Right.
Can other areas, can one change their record after discharge?
Yes. Yes, and it's very, very easy.
Easy for you to say.
Well, that's true, right? Because especially someone, sometimes discharges, you go out of the military and you may have unfavorable records in your file, maybe an Article 15, an LOR, something like that, and you just want to get it off your record. Or your discharge was a certain type of discharge. You may be able to get that upgraded so that you could obtain more benefits in the future, and there is a specific way of doing that.
Is it a long drawn out process, or is it something that is it basically filing paperwork? What's involved?
Well, it's a little bit of both.
Okay,
it's pretty easy to get an application in. You put something together. There's specific forms that you have to use, and you just write down your case, state what happened, state what you'd like to get out of it, and it goes to a board. And it's really what I call a board of equity. So it's folks in there that are looking at the case from an equitable basis, saying, hey, is this fair? Is that fair? Is it a good case? That sort of thing. And if you've got some good facts and a good argument, they can change your records.
Is it something that a lay person could do, or is it something that you recommend that someone go through an attorney to handle for?
Well, they can do it. A lay person can do it, especially if you know somebody in the JAG department or somebody in volunteers and some of the veterans organizations. They'll know how to do it as well. and they'll be able to access the forms. So you can do it, but if you don't know what you're looking at and don't know how to make a good argument or a good case or what facts are important,
okay,
then it's better to have somebody who does know a little bit more about that because it makes your case stronger.
Sure. And is it something that's expensive to hire somebody to do?
Not really.
Okay.
Especially if you go to one of the volunteer organizations, and there are several of them out there that are real well, they'll help people out. You can go to an attorney who specializes in this kind of thing, the veterans area, and they'll cost a little bit of money. But, you know, it's not too bad. It's not too crazy.
Not looking to retire off of a veterans case.
Correct. That's
maybe
right.
Maybe off of a 4,201 veterans. If you took on all of those cases,
right,
that might be a little different in the... the structure. I mean, figure 4,201. If you charge each of them $100, not a bad number, right?
That's a lot of money, right? And there's a lot of folks out there, a lot of practitioners out there, lawyers as well. I know that will help out veterans, and they do it just because they want to and stuff. So that's a good way of doing it. That's a good thing to do for somebody. Change a record. I've seen benefits increase. I've seen all kinds of things happen. Medals awarded afterwards, and so it can be really good.
How about upgrading from an unfavorable discharge? Is that all part of the same process?
Part of the same process, right? Because things happen. You get in, maybe you know you don't want to participate. Things happen. You don't end up with an honorable discharge when you get out, but you don't realize exactly what that means until down the road you start filling out job applications, things on there in Alaska military service. Did you get an honorable? And you're answering no. Certain things like that. So you're like, oh boy, I really wish I could fix that. And in some cases you can. You can go back in and apply and state your case, and you can get a discharge upgraded.
Interesting. So one of the areas that I would pursue, and again, I'm a civilian, I know nothing about law, and I know very little about military, but I have, you know, read some of the articles, talked to some of the folks. When you go into the military, especially in these times that we're in, you hear that there's end-of-life documents that are filled. Will, maybe trust, I don't know what they're all done.
Right.
When a person is discharged, those documents don't expire, do they?
Oh, no, that's a good question. So what we do is I'm a JAG. So
okay.
What I do...
Explain what a JAG is.
Judge Advocate General, so basically a lawyer.
Okay.
For the Air Force. So I know people have seen the show on TV.
Absolutely.
JAG.
Absolutely.
Okay, I wish it was that fun, but it's not quite like that.
Not quite
but,
that easy,
but close, right? So we do, you know, law stuff for the military, and we do it for the military itself and for the members that serve in the military. And one of the things we do is we prepare wills and estate documents, powers of attorneys, things like that. So if you prepare them for somebody and they leave the service, the will, for example, is still valid until they change it, or they lose it, or discard it, or destroy it, or whatever they want to do. It's still a valid document that does not expire when they leave service.
Okay, so then especially as you get older down the road, obviously, you want to make sure you update that, because, you know, if you go into the service at 18 years old, you're... choices may not be the same as once you've gotten married and had kids.
That's right.
15 years later.
Definitely want to look at it and change it. And if you retire from the military, whether it be active guard or reserve, Coast Guard, any of the branches, you still have access to those benefits. You can go in and see a legal assistance attorney and get a new one drafted even after you retire.
Really? Okay.
Yes, I do it all the time for retired military folks.
So make sure that, especially because, you know, obviously our flagship ESPN, we're right there near the bases down in San Diego. If you're listening, make sure you get these, take care of these things. These are very, very important, because whether you have an estate plan or not, you have an estate plan. It's either the one that you designated or the one that the governor has in place, right? So
that's right.
You got to make sure that you're dealing with these things and get it done the way you want to.
Yes, and I'll tell you, I've got a case right now where a gentleman just died and he can't find his will, and it's an absolute disaster. And so all it would take is 20, 30 minutes to create a will and just have it in place and ready to go in case something happens, because it's terrible without one.
Do you leave it with your attorney? Do you carry it with you, or have it, you know, because who knows whether you're going to lose it, have home fires and all these different catastrophes?
Yeah, that's a good question. I've heard of all kinds of ways of doing it. You can leave it with your attorney. They can lodge it. That's one way. But really, you want to have the original. That's executed. So it's better to have just one original, and then copies if you want them, but keep the original somewhere. I suggest a safe. If you don't have a safe or safe deposit box, I've seen people put them in freezers. So wrap them up in a bag and stick them in a freezer. So if you have
That's an interesting one.
Yeah. So if you have a fire, it's a good chance it might survive. Or you know, you give it to somebody, or you know, just put it somewhere, or have at least a copy around so somebody knows, just in case you can't find the original. Not the best, but it's an option.
I want to talk to you when we come back about what about on the cloud? That might be a thought process as well. I'm going to chat more with Randy Renfro when we come back. We're going to talk to Rick Rivera, veteran-owned carpet cleaning business. We'll chat with both of them as we come back. You're listening to Ron Siegel Radio, discussing your real estate current events and the financial markets. You can reach us anytime. Call our off-air number, 800-306-1990, 800-306-1990, or ronsiegelradio.com. Connect with us, facebook.com/Ron Siegel Radio. And if you miss any part of our broadcast, Ron Siegel 1 on YouTube. Stay tuned. We'll be back in just a few.
Is your credit score over 800? Are you living in the home of your dreams or simply where you think you can afford? Are you earning a safe, secure 10-plus percent return on your investments? If the answer to any of these questions is no, what are you doing about it? Text ATP to 79564. Complete a 3-minute complimentary survey and the area trusted professionals of Ron Siegel Radio will reach out to you to develop a success strategy for you. Again, all you need to do is text ATP to 79564.
Are you purchasing or own a luxury home? If you're like so many others, your home is your largest asset and the mortgage is your largest debt. The Siegel Lending Team has some amazing financing opportunities right now. Jumbo loans up to $2 million, 30-year rates below 4%, 15-year rates near 3.5%, and if you can believe it, 7-year interest-only hybrids in low threes. The Siegel Lending Team has all the options for your jumbo or second home loan requirements. Take advantage of them while you can. To learn more about all the other financing products available from the Siegel Lending Team, call 1-800-306-1990. That's 1-800-306-1990. Or visit SiegelLendingTeam.com. That's S-I-E-G-E-L LendingTeam.com. Again, call 1-800-306-1990. Rates subject to change without notice. Licensed by NMLS ID 217037 and 145502. Equal housing lender.
Are you ready to overcome your biggest blocks with money and time? Your solution? Big Profits Now World Summit. The best skills and strategies to double and triple your business profits without doubling or tripling the work. This summit has gathered 24 experts specializing in business growth. It's a free online event that's happening now. Go immediately to claim your free ticket at BigProfitsNowLive.com. Enter your name and email and receive these free video interviews directly to your inbox. Again, that's BigProfitsNowLive.com.
Are you a veteran, own a home, and need money? The Siegel Lending Team is here to help veterans refinance and get the money they need. The VA 100 lets you borrow up to 100% of your home's value, refinance your mortgages, consolidate credit cards, and lower your payments by an average of $700 a month. And the Siegel Lending Team knows that character means more than a credit score. Call 800-306-1990. That's 800-306-1990. Rates subject to change without notice. Licensed by the California Department of Corporations, NMLS 21037, and DRE number 01869452.
37% of American homeowners believe they have over 20% equity in their homes. Fannie Mae tells us 69% of American homeowners have over 20% equity in their homes. Fully 1 in 3 American homeowners are not informed about the amount of equity they have in their homes. Are you one of them? How might this be holding you back from achieving your goals? Text RSR CMA to 79564 to get a property valuation from one of the area trusted professionals of Ron Siegel Radio. Again, to know how much your home is really worth, simply text RSR CMA to 79564.
You're listening to Ron Siegel's Home and Finance Show with local and national expert Ron Siegel. Now, here's Ron.
Welcome back to Ron Siegel Radio. Within every market, there are solutions as well as tremendous opportunities. You just need some trusted guidance. That's my message, and as your consumer advocate, I will be delivering it every day on Ron Siegel Radio or anytime at 800-306-1990, 800-306-1990. The Mortgage Minute today being brought to you by VIP Mortgage. Yes, they do have every one of the products, well, just about every product that you could possibly want. They might even be accessing this new product that I was chatting with you about earlier this week. How about no income, no documentation loans coming back? not at an outrageous interest rate. There is a new fund, $2 billion lending out some money here. Nice fund there. You might want to give us a call and I'll put you in touch with the people that have it. What is the difference between a fixed rate mortgage and an adjustable rate mortgage, and which should you use when and why? So the answer here is quite simple, and it's really just what they're saying. Fixed rate mortgages means it's going to be fixed for the entire duration of the loan. There are adjustable rate mortgages that do change during the life of the loan, but how about that hybrid? There's a 5-year, and my favorite is the 7-year. It's adjustable after it's got a fixed period, 7 years fixed, then it starts adjusting. And I use that a lot. I tell people that's one of the best loans out there. Now, obviously, it's not nearly as good as the VA loan. That's the absolute best loan on the market. But the adjustable rate, this hybrid fixed to adjustable, is great because we only keep our loans in this country for 5.2 years. If you've got an adjustable that's going to stay the same for 7 years, you're going to save a little bit of money, and it's going to be fixed for the time that you're going to actually have that loan, because life happens. We decide that we want to move, we want to do home improvements, we want to change our property, we want to take cash out, consolidate debt. There's all different reasons that we refinance our loans. Check into that product if you're not familiar with it. It's a 7-year fixed to adjustable. And a lot of this has to do with understanding what is your plan. How long do you plan on staying in the property? Where's the economy? Are you going to need a bigger house, a smaller house? And again, one of the options that you look at is if you're doing an FHA loan, use an adjustable rate there too if there's enough of a spread. Because one of the big things you want to do with an adjustable rate loan, with an FHA loan, is get out of it. It is a great loan for getting started, but the idea is to get rid of it as quick as you can and get rid of that mortgage insurance. So why not pay the lower rate for as long as you can? Just a thought there, the differences and usages of a fixed rate versus an adjustable rate mortgage. Again, the Mortgage Minute brought to you by VIP Mortgage. So as we are continuing our appreciation of our veterans this week, Rick Rivera is in the house. A veteran-owned business, carpet cleaning.
Yes, sir.
So tell us a little bit about carpet cleaning and how you got into that following your service in the military.
I was discharged from the Marine Corps in 92, and I happened to be engaged to a lady who was taking care of homes at the time, and one of her clients asked if we could clean carpet, and, you know, I just thought, throw water on the floor and, you know, vacuum it up, and then it would be great.
Well, for somebody that doesn't even know what end of a screwdriver to use, is that not what you do? Is there more to it than that?
Well, yes. I've currently been educated in the standard of cleaning through a group called the IICRC, and they give us education and testing so that we can be up to date on all our equipment and agents that we use for the cleaning.
So when you look at it, is all carpet created the same?
No, all carpet is not created the same. We have different variances depending on the weight, the types of fiber, when you go to clean, the types of soils that you have to identify so that you know you're using the right agent at the proper time in the cleaning cycle.
So can you end up having a need for multiple agents?
Well, you know, we have what they call compound stains. And
I have compound stains too. I have kids and I have a dog.
Yes, you
do. So it's got a compound right there.
Right. And that's what we see a lot in the industry, is that there will be a Kool-Aid dropped on this part of the carpet. And then since there's sugar, it attracts soil. So you might get gum. And then you have to have two different agents, once to remove the gum and then to remove the red stain.
And we won't talk about the red wine that might get spilled.
Red wine is easy.
Is it really?
It's very easy.
I can have a few more glasses tonight.
You can have as many as you'd like, sir.
So that's an easy one. Is it a normal fee, a flat fee, or how do you deal with what the cost is going to be?
You know, every company does it a different way.
Okay.
Some people use an hourly rate, how they figure it out. Some people do a room rate, and they advertise it as such. We utilize a square footage rate. This way, everybody pays the same amount based on the square footage, and it keeps it fair.
So then if I only wanted a portion of the house done, if I only say want downstairs done, then that's all I'm going to be paying for is just for that, whatever that cost is.
Right. And the way we do it here at Carpet Pro is we only measure the amount of available carpet to clean. Other corporations and companies may measure the whole room, and they don't even move the items that need to be moved to clean under it.
Ah, okay. So if you've got heavy furniture that's not going to be moved.
Right.
Then you don't need to, you don't pay for that.
Well, correct. And a lot of clients don't want it moved for the most part, especially like hutches and, you know, entertainment centers and such like that, because, you know, they don't want to move it.
Yeah, I can understand that. That would be a lot of work to move an entertainment center and all that remounting and electronics and then all that stuff that I don't understand.
Exactly, and I don't understand it either, so that's why we don't move it.
How long does it take to clean a house, or is there... Per square foot or whatever, however you figure.
You know, at about 500 feet per hour is what we can clean at, and to clean effectively and efficiently. So a 1,500 square foot home of cleanable carpet, about 2.5 hours.
And then how long do I have to stay out of there?
You can walk on it immediately. We give our clients some vinyl booties so that they can wear it. They can walk on it immediately. And then it also helps protect that carpet for them, you know, walking on their shoes and empowering some kind of contaminant back onto the carpet.
How often do I need to do my carpet?
You know, the mills recommend every 6 to 9 months. There are caveats to that, and that depends on how many people you have inside, the outside environment, your indoor environment. I have clients once every 2 years, and it's fine. I have clients once a month.
Once a month?
Yes, sir.
Oh, I thought I heard that if when you do it that often that you're going to end up breaking down the backs of the carpet. Is that a myth?
Well, no. What happens when you're not trained professionally, a lot of carpet cleaning companies overwet the carpet. The face fibers are the only thing that should be wet, okay, or damp.
How do you stop it between the two?
You get training.
Ah.
And it's all about the training and dedication to make sure it doesn't get that way. High-end equipment, high-end training, high-end cleaning agents.
Interesting. So, being that we are in the state of confusion here, there's got to be some differences for environmental. Green, is it green solvents or?
You know, we have green cleaning.
Okay.
And we,
it doesn't change the carpet color.
It does not change the carpet color.
Okay.
The only thing that really will change the color of the carpet is if sun, and we call that fume fading. And we have people using agents that are not made for carpet cleaning, going to the Walmart or the Home Depot or whatever and buying ABC cleaner.
I would do something like that.
Most people do.
I'm pretty ignorant about any of these.
Well,
things
you know, it's not that people are ignorant. People are being sold a bill when they go, you know, they watch TV or they see the little ad on the at the store.
So I guess it's the idea of if someone's doing this properly, if they're doing it professionally, you're going to know not to put as much water on there. So I can actually have a party the same night that you come and clean.
Yes, you can. And we can use enhanced drying techniques. You know, here in California, it's mostly warm most of the time, except we've had a longer, cooler period because of global warming here lately. So it's been cooler longer here.
Global warming and it's cooler.
Yes, it is. It works that way. But what we may have to utilize the AC system, or we may have to utilize the heating system to get a happy medium.
Interesting. Great information. Veteran-owned business. You got to support our veterans. I mean, I share this all the time. If it wasn't for our veterans, how could I get up in the morning every day and spout off some of the things that we do during our monologue in the morning if it wasn't for the veterans fighting and some giving their lives for our freedom? So support the veterans. They're the ones that allow us to do what we do, to have the freedom that we have, and appreciate that. Appreciate you sharing the information, Rick.
Well, thank you. It was a pleasure.
Glad to have you in with us. You're listening to Ron Siegel Radio, discussing your real estate current events and the financial markets. When we come back, more with Rick Rivera, Randy Renfro, and we will continue our celebration or our honoring of veterans as we get into Memorial Day, which is not a celebration. For those of you that are not familiar with that, you might want to look it up. But you can reach us anytime. Our off-air number, 800-306-1990, 800-306-1990, or ronsiegelradio.com. Connect with us, facebook.com/ronsiegelradio, on Twitter, @ronsiegel. And if you miss any part of our broadcast, ronsiegel1, Ron Siegel the numeral 1 on YouTube. Stay tuned. We'll be back in just a few.
Are you living in the home of your dreams or simply where you think you can afford? Are you earning a safe, secure 10-plus percent return on your investments? Is your credit score over 800? If the answer to any of these questions is no, what are you doing about it? Text ATP to 79564. Complete a 3-minute complimentary survey and the area trusted professionals of Ron Siegel Radio will reach out to you to develop a success strategy for you. Again, all you need to do is text ATP to 79564.
Isn't it time you found out the truth about FHA-insured home equity conversion? No, it's not your grandfather's reverse mortgage. This just may be the finest financial planning strategy available for all homeowners of retirement age. Helping protect what you've earned is the job of your board of directors with continued education. Major research has shown that using a HECM will significantly enhance the success rate of a retiree's portfolio and legacy. Please allow us to educate. For your complimentary consultation, call Jay Kaplan at 949-300-3855. That's 949-300-3855.
Homeowners that are 62 and older are about to find out a great way to live a better retirement. It's called a reverse mortgage, and SLT can help you learn more. Call the Siegel Lending Team at 800-306-1990 right now to receive your free booklet with no obligation. It answers questions like how a reverse mortgage works, how much you qualify for, the ways to receive your money, and more. When you call the experts at Siegel Lending Team today, you'll learn the benefits of a government-insured reverse mortgage, how it will eliminate your monthly mortgage payments, and give you tax-free cash from the equity in your home. Here's the best part. You still own your home. Now is the best time to take control of your retirement. Call 800-306-1990. That's 800-306-1990 to get your free brochure. Call today or visit our website at SiegelLendingTeam.com. That's S-I-E-G-E-L LendingTeam.com. Or simply call 800-306-1990.
You have a goal of mortgage-free home ownership. What if your home was valued at $500,000? Are you aware that a free and clear home could be costing you $2,500 every month, $30,000 per year? The mortgage planners at the Siegel Lending Team would like to show you how you can own your home, generate tax-free income, and accumulate family wealth. You simply need to call the Ron Siegel Team at 1-800-306-1990. That is 1-800-306-1990. By sending the team a copy of your most recent mortgage statement, the team will send you a no-obligation real estate plan. You be the judge if this is right for your family. Again, all you have to do is send the team a copy of your mortgage statement by email to REAP at ronsiegelradio.com or call today, Ron Siegel, 1-800-306-1990. That is 1-800-306-1990.
Rates subject to change and without notice. Licensed by the California DOC and BRENMLS 217037 and 145502 and CalBRE 01869452 and 1866775.
Summer fun starts at Toyota Carlsbad with humongous savings on new and used Toyotas. During the Surf's Up Prices Down sales event. See awesome daily specials online at toyotacarlsbad.com.
You're listening to Ron Siegel's Home and Finance Show with local and national expert Ron Siegel. Now, here's Ron.
Welcome back to Ron Siegel Radio. Within every market, there are solutions as well as tremendous opportunities. You just need some trusted guidance. That's my message, and as your consumer advocate, I will be delivering it every day on Ron Siegel Radio. Or anytime at 800-306-1990, 800-306-1990. The Your Credit Matters segment today being brought to you by CreditSanitizer.com. You have a credit report? It is wrong. They all are. That's why I know yours is too. I don't care what they say. I've watched some of these reports that say that there's 25% of them are wrong. And I've seen some that say 35% are wrong. And I've been looking at credit reports since the 90s. And I have never, ever seen a credit report that's accurate. Never seen one that's completely accurate. Now, I'm not talking about perfect scores. I'm just talking about accuracy. I've seen some scores in the 830 range, and they've got errors on them just like everybody else. You got to look at your credit report. If you're thinking about buying a house, buying a car, buying furniture, getting a credit card, you have to understand these. So some credit myths. Credit repair does not work. That is a myth. It does work if you've got a reputable company working on that with you. If you want a reputable company, I will put you in touch with one. Again, I'd watch what they're doing. Do not push that little button on the side of the credit reports that come from the bureaus that says dispute now. That doesn't work. That's the credit repair that does not work. There are documents, there are laws that you can use, and you have to send in the paperwork for it. Negative information that can be verified cannot be removed. That is a myth as well. The law says, and I'm not a lawyer, but here's the way I understand it, that basically the only thing that can be on a credit report is that which is accurate, complete, and verifiable. Accurate, complete, and verifiable. If they don't verify it in the right amount of time, it needs to be removed. If it's not complete, it needs to be removed. And obviously, if it's not accurate, it needs to be removed. There is nothing that has to be on a credit report. We see frequently bankruptcies coming off a credit report because they forget to put the judge's initials at the end of the case number. That is part of the case number. If it's not there, it's not complete. Got to understand those things. Credit repair agencies are scams. Well, I'm not going to say that they're not, but there are some that are. So again, you got to know the right ones. Check the Better Business Bureau. Give us a call, and I can do some research on them for you as well. You have to hire a law firm or credit repair agency to repair your credit. That is not true. There are other services that will do this for you. Again, it goes back to step one. If I just pay off my delinquent accounts and make all my payments on time, my score will improve it by itself. Again, big myth. I've seen many credit reports where somebody filed bankruptcy and all the items that were discharged in the bankruptcy, or many of the items discharged in the bankruptcy, still appear on the report. The bureaus make more money the lower your score is. Now, am I being a conspiracy theorist? You decide. That is the Your Credit Matters segment, again, brought to you by CreditSanitizer.com. Continuing our conversation, we have got Rick Rivera, veteran-owned carpet cleaning business, in the house. And Randy Renfro, attorney and CPA, is in the house with us. We've been having some interesting conversations. If you've missed it, shame on you, but the replay will be on YouTube a little later today. Ron Siegel 1 on YouTube. Some of you might even be watching us right now, RonSiegelRadio.tv. As you can tell there, if you're watching, I do have a face for radio, so it's really nice that we get nice guests coming in on a regular basis, so you're not staring at my mug. So, Randy, there's so many questions. Unfortunately, you know, right now we're finishing off Military Appreciation Month.
Right.
Obviously, we've got Memorial Day on Monday. A lot of people think that that's time for a barbecue, and you know, a lot of people, that it is a good time. You got to remember what that's all about.
Right.
Right? I mean, there's a lot of people that have served and given their lives, and I'm sure both of you, being military, know a lot more people than I do who have sacrificed.
Right, correct.
And we got to remember that that's what this is really all about.
Correct.
Right? I mean, there's different events that, I don't want to put you guys on the spot, but I will for... Are there specific events that you appreciate more or attend more on Veterans Day? I mean, I didn't even know that they were out there. As far as, you know, I went to Yorba Linda Memorial Park last year, Placentia Memorial Park. Great celebration there. Have you gone to some of these? Or do veterans want to be at these things? They want to try and avoid them? Is it bring back bad memories?
I think it's a little bit of all of that.
Yeah, I do too.
Do you?
Yeah. So yeah. One of the coolest things I ever did was I took my family, parents and sister and whatnot, to Pearl Harbor on December 7th. Several years ago, and there they had a number of the veterans from that day.
Wow.
That were there.
Wow.
And it was just interesting to sit there and talk with them, and it's somber. It's not a celebration, but it's not a funeral. It's really not anything that's normal. It's just different.
Kind of like a big emptiness, I would think.
Yes.
Right?
Yes.
I mean, because again, like you said, it's not a sell. I know when I went and visited Pearl Harbor, you do feel a million emotions, right? I mean, I don't know whether everybody does it this way. I felt pride, patriotism, anger, frustration.
Right.
Right? I mean, you feel all of that stuff. You know, and obviously, it's kind of a interesting scenario watching, especially with talking about that, with the president laying a wreath in Hiroshima today. I mean, that was kind of an interesting...
Right.
Interesting feeling. It's very, this time of year.
This time of year, especially this holiday is coming up, or Memorial is coming up.
Yeah.
It's just a day of reflection.
Reflection.
I would say that's probably the best.
Interesting. Okay.
Way to put it.
Because you always wonder. I mean, I had Elaine Roach was here yesterday, and she's lost her dad and her son both in active combat. And she made a comment that, you know, you can't bring up something that's going to make us feel bad because we always remember that.
Right.
And I would assume that having served you guys, it's not something you forget.
No.
No. It's never.
Interesting. So let's talk a little bit about the legal sides of these, Randy. Benefits, I mean, one of the things that when I talk to military, they seem like, you know, that obviously our military men and women are unbelievable people. But when they are discharged, they seem like they're kind of thrown to the wolves by the government.
Right. That terrible thing. Yes. Like they're all alone.
Yeah.
Like when you're in the service, they basically tell you everything, what to wear, when to eat, you know, when to show up for work, when to go home, everything. And then when you're out the next day, it's like you're on your own.
Where do you go to understand what your benefits are, and can you help somebody get benefits that may not have applied for them right when they left?
See, there are a couple of different options. I mean, if you're retired, then of course you've got a lot of options. There's a lot of places you can go. The Veterans Administration is a good place to go. But if you haven't retired, you've just done a certain period of time, 4 years, 6 years, or whatever, then there's websites you can go to see what your benefits are. So we talked about correction of records. The website is the BCMR, Border Correction of Military Records. So you can go there, and you can look online for these things, and they'll get you in touch with certain places with a person that you can talk to, depending on what your issue is. There are a lot of organizations that are out here that are around. Veterans organizations. We have a legal one that in San Diego that I've got some friends that do, and they do just legal stuff for veterans. And so, and there are several others. I'm sure you know plenty of them. That's a good place to start.
And there, I don't know if it's a national organization or if it's just California, but there's special services if a military man or woman gets in trouble legally. There are different channels, if they know what they're doing, that they can go through.
Yes, there's some really cool stuff out there. There's actually a separate court system that is used to deal just with veteran issues. And it's not veteran issues related to the person, like against the military or something like that. It's for veterans. They might have a real estate issue or a criminal issue or something like that, and they'll get judges in there that have experience with the military folks, and they work a lot on rehabilitation of folks and helping folks out, and I've seen those things be very successful.
And, you know, one of the things that I like to promote all the time is make sure you take a look at some of the dog organizations. I don't know the exact terminology, but there's a lot of benefits we're seeing with the service dogs.
Yes.
For veterans. We want to make sure that we remember those, especially with this mission that we have 22-0. So remember that there are those organizations as well. Does the, you know, we hear from time to time about constitutional double jeopardy. If the state prosecutes us for something, can the military then come behind them?
Oh boy, I hear that a lot. So let's put an example to it. Let's say you're in the service and you get a DUI. Terrible, terrible, terrible thing, right? And the question is, well, what happens to you? So is it the military or is it the state? And so a lot of people say, well, the state, you know, did one thing and let me go, and that's the end of it. Not so, because they are different sovereigns.
Okay.
And the military will have jurisdiction over you as well. So some people look at it as getting in trouble twice. But I'm, you know, it's not really that way. But you can get in trouble from both.
Great information. If you want to meet any of our guests, give us a call, 800-306-1990. Be sure to set that first radio preset button to come back here every day to join Ron Siegel Radio, where we speak about items affecting your house and your bank account. And remember, make a lot of money, help a lot of people, have a lot of fun. Have a great day. We'll talk to you next time on Ron Siegel Radio.
This lunch break is gonna take all afternoon.
This AKA music samples are in the
You're listening to ESPN Radio 1700.